Dear students, I am Dr. Rajiv Sapre and this is the 76th audio for you. In this audio, I will introduce you the concept called integration. One thing you keep in mind, integration is a reverse of derivative. So whenever you say derivative of sin x is cos x, integration of cos x is sin x. As it was derivative with respect to x, here also it is integration with respect to x. So if your function is cos x, whenever I want to find integration of cos x, it means I am finding a function whose derivative is cos x. Integration of cos x is a function whose derivative is cos x. Now what is a function whose derivative is cos x? Sin x. But in that, suppose I add some constant. Suppose I take sin x plus 1, its derivative is also cos x. Derivative of sin x plus 1 is also cos x. Derivative of sin x plus 2, it is also cos x. Derivative of sin x plus, in general, any constant c will be cos x. And that is why integration of cos x will be written as sin x plus c, where c is called as the constant of integration. You can put any value of c there and take derivative, it will be cos x. As I told, sin x plus 1, sin x plus 2, sin x plus k, where k can take any value, any real number, k can be any real number, all those functions will have same derivative, cos x. And that is why integration is not unique. Very important sentence, integration is not unique. Derivative is unique. Why unique? Because derivative is limit. Limit of certain function is derivative. And so you always know that limit of the function when it exists is unique. So derivative is also unique. But integration of the function is not necessarily unique. Why? Just now you have seen that. Okay. So now see, as I told, integration is reverse procedure of derivative. What I mean by that? See, if your function is x square and if you calculate its derivative, it will be 2x. You know, you can use the formula x raised to n and derivative of x square is 2x. So I will say integration of 2x is x square plus c. That plus c is to be added. Because whenever I take x square plus c, where c is any constant, its derivative is 2x. What is the value of c? Any real number can be there. That means integration of 2x is not just x square. X square is one of that. But it is x square plus c, where c is any constant. That c can be 0. If c is 0, it is just x square. But x square plus 1 when I take, its derivative is also 2x. Right? Are you getting this? So integration is never unique. Derivative was unique. Integration is not unique. If you know formulae for derivative, then using those formulae, you can get the formulae for integration, basic formulae, naturally. But then as we saw in case of derivatives, here also we are interested in knowing what is geometrical interpretation of this indefinite integral. What is geometrical interpretation of this integration. Okay, so now by this you know that if you have a function fx, okay, and if I calculate its derivative, that means d by dx of fx, which is f dash x, suppose it is gx. Also you know that d by dx of fx plus c is also gx, where c is any constant. And this means integration of gx is fx plus c, integration of gx dx. So integration symbol you must know. and then you will write integration of gx dx as it was d pi dx of fx. Here it is integration with respect to x, integral dx, and in between you will write that function. So whenever I am saying integral x square dx, what I mean, I am taking integration of x square with respect to x. As it was derivative with respect to x, this is integration with respect to x. So integration of gx will be fx plus c. We see that the integral of the function is not unique. There exist infinitely many integrals of each of the function which can be obtained by using different values of c. Okay, suppose f dash x is 1. I will explain this idea. Suppose f dash of x is 1. Okay, then what is fx? F dash x, suppose it is 1. What is fx? F dash x is derivative of fx, right? So integration of f dash x is fx. Integration of f dash x is fx. So if f dash x is 1, what is fx? It is integration of 1 with respect to x. So integral 1 dx. What is integration 1 dx? It is the set of functions whose derivative is 1, and that set of functions is what? X plus c, where c is any real number. Hence integration of 1 is x plus c, where c is any real number. Now this function x plus c, you concentrate on, it will be y is equal to x plus c, suppose I write, or f of x is equal to x plus c. What will be its graph? Whenever you see, it is y is equal to x plus c, it means c can be 0, so it is y is equal to x, y is equal to x plus 1, y is equal to x plus 2, y is equal to x plus 3, y is equal to x minus 1, y is equal to x minus 2, etc. So these will be parallel lines. What are these? These are parallel lines. Okay, so whenever I say that f dash x is 1, then integration of 1 is x plus c. It means it represents the curves y is equal to x plus c. So they are, if you draw the graphs, y is equal to x plus c when I take, and I am also knowing that c can be any real number, then you will get a linear equations where y is equal to x plus some constant. Now y is equal to x plus some constants, this is what? This is a set of parallel lines. This is set of parallel lines. Another example you take. Suppose I am given that f dash x is x, derivative of f x, derivative of f of x is x, then fx is its integration, right? Fx is its integration. Suppose I take f dash x is equal to say 2x, instead of x, it take 2x, then 2x is derivative of what? X square. So what will be the integration of 2x dx? It will be x square plus c. Integration of 2x dx will be x square plus c. Why? Because x square plus c, derivative of x square plus c is 2x, because derivative of c is 0. So whenever I am taking this integration of x with respect to integration of, sorry, 2x with respect to x, then it is y is equal to x square plus c. That is the integration. Now here c can be any real number. If c is 0, then it is a parabola, y is equal to x square. If c is 1, it is again a parabola, y is equal to x square plus 1. If c is 2, it is again a parabola, y is equal to x square plus 2, etc. So you can see that this integration of 2x with respect to x is a set of parabolas, and their equations are y is equal to x square plus c. So this represents family of curves parallel to each other. This was parabola. In previous example, it was set of straight lines parallel to each other. So integration, indefinite integration, whenever you calculate, it represents family of similar curves which are parallel to each other. This is the geometrical interpretation of integration. This is very important. You should always know any idea that you are studying in mathematics, like limits, then say this derivative, then integration. Afterwards, you will study definite integral. What is their geometrical interpretation? Right? There are books devoted for this. Geometrical interpretation of the ideas in calculus. Right? You see, mathematics is not just solving problems. Just don't think what type of problems will be asked in unit test, what type of problems will be asked in HSC board question paper. It's okay. Those who just want to pass, just want to get through this junior college business, then it is okay. But really, if you are interested in getting knowledge of that subject, then you should know all the aspects, all the things related with that particular mathematical idea. So as I discussed, geometrical interpretation of derivative, you know what was that geometrical interpretation of derivative? Derivative of the function y is equal to f of x at the point where x is equal to a means it is the slope of the tangent drawn to the curve y is equal to fx at point x is equal to a. Similarly, whenever any function is given and if you are finding its integration, then that integration is a family of similar curves which are parallel to each other. This is the, and very important thing is derivative is unique because it is limit of certain function, and limit when it exists is unique. So derivative is unique and integration is not unique. Integration of a given function is not unique. There are many functions whose derivative is that function. But derivative of the function is unique. See, all these ideas, they are very, very important because you should know at the end of the year, you should, if you are asked by anyone, what is difference between derivative and integration? The first answer should be integration is a reverse procedure of derivative. What do you mean by that? Derivative of x square is 2x, so integration of 2x is x square. Derivative of sin x is cos x, so integration of cos x is sin x. Derivative of log x is 1 upon x, so integration of 1 upon x is log x, like that. So derivative and integration are what we can say, opposite of each other. Right? If you take a function and you want to calculate its integration, means you have to find a function whose derivative is the given function. In that sense, integration and derivative are reverse processes of each other. Then also you should know what are their geometrical interpretation. What that derivative geometrically means. What that integration geometrically means. Then after that you should know varieties of all the formulae related to derivative. All the formulae related to integration. See, this is just a beginning. And now, as you developed by using first principle of derivative, formulae of derivative, here it is not necessary. Here already you know now the formulae of derivative. So by using reverse procedure of derivative, sometimes integration is called antiderivative. Why antiderivative? Reverse of derivative. So by knowing the formulae of derivative, you can calculate formulae of integration. How? Suppose I know that derivative of sin x is cos x. So I will say integration of cos x is sin x plus c. This plus c must be added. And this is constant of integration. Afterwards, you will study a concept of definite integral. It means you are integrating that function over a certain interval. Now, when you do that, then there is no that plus c is not to be added, right? Because it is a definite integral. You are actually getting numerical value of the integration. because you are integrating over certain given interval, closed interval or open interval, whatever it may be, but you are integrating over an interval. That is definite integral. Definite integral, if you want to study, you should be very strong in this indefinite integral, right? So this is the just the introduction of integration. I hope you enjoyed this audio. Thank you.